Hey, welcome back to onestoptutorials.com. Ali Baba here again. Okay, we're continuing on from the last lesson. In the last one, we made ourselves our information with our shopping cart. Now we just want to duplicate it. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to click, select this table. This is just one way of doing it. There's many ways. I mean, we could hit tab and put all the information in again. But what I want to do is I want to select this table, and you can make sure you selected it by hitting table. I want to do Control C to copy, okay, and then at the side of this table I want to hold Shift Enter, and I want to do Control V, okay, and you'll notice that we have, oh, my phone's going now, it's just non-stop. Give me 2 seconds, guys. So we've duplicated that information, and now we want to edit it. What I want to do is I actually want to delete this shopping cart from there because it will take too long to explain the problems it causes. It's just better to do our own one again. So this cell here is gone back to default, which means it's centered, so we just want to come down to vertical, hit top, and we'll move that up. Okay, so as you can see, we got exactly the duplicate information. We now want to change some stuff, obviously, so we want to come into our website, images, special offers, and white knight. So I'm going to show you a way of doing this. You can click on the image, left click on the image, and if you come down to this link here, SRC, at the end here there's a little point of view. You simply left click, drag with your left finger on the mouse button, click white knight, and it will change that picture. Very nice. I love that user friendliness. Next thing we want to do is come to the text file, special editions, double click on white knight, and again we're going to do what we did last time. Control C to copy that. I'm also close that down, and then we're just gonna paste that into here. Let me close this window down. Control V, paste, and we're gonna paste that in there. We don't need the price, $19.99 at the bottom. That can go. Okay, so we're looking good. We got the double information in now. Next thing next, this looks like, this div tag looks like it's lost its class, okay, lost its name. So we could either click in the middle of the div tag, choose div, okay, and you'll notice it's called it div ID or div. We don't really want that, okay. What we're going to do is we're going to name this back to what it was before, which was price, okay. And yep, it's asking us, it's already on there, do you want to duplicate it, and we hit yes. So now we have it back. And the next thing I want to do, the last thing I want to do, is add our shopping cart. So I'm going to click right to the next of the cell. I'm going to hold down Shift Enter, and that's going to allow me to insert stuff here underneath the price. So let's come back into our files, shopping cart, fat free cart, double click, and this is what I want. I want it from form to form, okay. After that it says put in between the head. We just want from form to form. Right click, copy, let's close that down as well, and I'm going to paste that again. Let me just click at the edge here, hit Control Enter, and come into my code, and I'm going to Control V, okay. And what we want to do is, coming right to the top of it, remember it started with form. This time we want to put our div tag back in. So remember how we did it last time, so the bracket div, but this time we're going to actually get you to name this now. So watch what happens once you've typed in your back slat, your back bracket div, and you hit space on your keyboard. It comes up with some drop down options. What do you want to do? Well, we have an ID, so we want to ID it. And you'll notice what happens is it adds the rest of the information and brings up what we have already made. So in this instance, the one we want is called shopping. You hit enter and then you close it, and there you go. You've just made your div thing very easy, so the system knows what you are trying to do. So if you open one, we've got to make sure we close one, and we come to the bottom where it says form, and we do the back bracket, and then we hit backslash on our keyboard. And watch what happens, it just automatically closes it for us. So when we come back into our design view and we go into the browser to preview this, preview in Firefox, you'll notice everything is set up, but we seem to have a little bit of space here. Okay, so let's come back in and see if we can work out how to delete that. So what we could do is we could come in here and try to mess it around, but more than likely the reason it has a space there is because it has a bracket, it has a break tag in it. So again, if we click anywhere inside of any of this coding, come back to the code view, and we look where we started here, div ID shopping, and if you look above it, we have this thing here. This is this gives you a break, it gives you a space. So we simply just want to delete that. Now when we come back in and we preview this in the browser, fingers crossed, it all works correct. There you go. We notice we got rid of that space. And if you wanted to add that space back in again, you know, see here it's gone. If we wanted to add a space in between the two of these, so say they're too close, okay, we simply, if we click on the bottom table, so it selects the whole table, or click inside it and select table, okay, come back into the code view, it will show you where it ends here, and then we would just type that in ourselves, backslash b, br slash and close. Now when we come back in to preview this, you'll notice we have a space in between our stuff, so very handy. One last thing we've got to do before my kids get back from school and the whole place will be manic. I want to change a few things in the hidden field. One is the, let's bring up the properties. One is the amounts, okay. Item number. We need to change it different from this item number. So in this instance, we're just going to call it item number 2, okay. We also need to change the item name. This is called White Knight. White Knight, White Knight, if I can spell, geez man, let me just tidy this up. It's all going wrong. Okay, White Knight, and everything else is okay, it's all the same, shipping and stuff like that. The next thing, last thing I want to do is I want to hit after the end of White Knight, after the two dots here, I want to hit enter, and I want to make this top one our heading one tag, this here is our paragraph tag. I'm going to do the same up here. After the word Dragon Age, the two dots, hit enter, and make this our heading one. Okay, and there we go. Looking good. Let's preview this in the browser one more time. Looking good. Let's test our shopping cart. Dragon Age, come on, please work. There you go. You'll notice we have one product called Dragon Age. If we continue shopping and come down here to this cart, hopefully it will add that next one. And there you go. Dragon Age and White Knight had added, and then they can check out now or continue shopping. Okay, so that, as you can see, all's working well. We got our information in. If we wanted to, we could add that image to the left here like we did last time. We just come back to, what was it, images, banner left, drag that into the left hand side, name it banner left, and hit okay. There's our banner left. We're just going to preview this in the browser one more time. Okay, there you go, looking really, really good. We've just done some div tags, we've just done the shopping cart. You now know how to do it all. If I come back into the shopping cart one more time, just check that everything is working well. Change the quantity to 20, update the cart. Yep, so 20. And then for this tutorial, we're going to check out and make sure it all goes to PayPal, make sure everything is working correctly. But this is so powerful because this keeps you on their website instead of every time having to go to PayPal. PayPal is one of the slowest websites in the world, I reckon. And when we get into PayPal so the customer can check out, you'll notice quantity 20, there's the amount, there's the White Knight, Dragon Age, and they can fill in their details to check out their shopping. That's it, we've done our next page. If we wanted to be really, really smart about this, we could just type in the top here, special editions, add it the H1 tag, and there we go. We are done. Let's preview it one more time. There we go. Ladies and gents, you have just built your first shopping cart. Take it easy. Catch you at the next one-stop tutorials. Any questions, please let me know or subscribe to my YouTube. Check out my website. I shall see you lot very, very, very soon. Take it easy.